Hello, my dear friends. Today we are going to learn about new topic, that is DNA. DNA, which is the type of nucleic acid, and it is called as the miraculous organic compound. Why? Because all the information of life is loaded in the DNA in the form of nucleotide, as I told you. In this way, this miraculous organic compound means DNA was, this term was first of all coined by one scientist, that is Johann Friedrich Miescher, which is one of the Swiss biologists, and in 1869 when studied on WBC, actually he observed the network like structure, the helix structure in the white blood cell and coined the term, that is DNA. In this way, in today's video, we will take the whole information of DNA, means regarding its structure, who discovered, how the nitrogenous bases are arranged, how the structure look alike, and at the end phase, types of DNA. And you all are able to understand, or you can find out some important checkpoints which is useful for your study. So now first of all, start from who discovered the structure of DNA. Actually, the structure of DNA was discovered by Watson and Crick along with R. Franklin and Wilkins with the help of one technique, is X-ray crystallography. But who discovered the structure of DNA? The right answer is that Watson and Crick. But here one important twist, you should know what is that. Actually, Watson and Crick did not conduct any experiment on the structure of DNA. Understand? They did not conduct any experiment or any type of cell. But out of these two scientists, Watson was expert in viral and bacterial genetics, and Crick was expert in physics, like one technique, that is X-ray crystallography. So actual experiment was performed by these two scientists, R. Franklin and M. Wilkins. Means R. Franklin and A. Wilkins were performed the experiment on the structure of DNA, but the results were analyzed and comprehended by these two scientists, that is Watson and Crick. Understand? That's why who performed experiment on the structure of DNA? First checkpoint, your answer should be R. Franklin and A. Wilkins. Second, which technique used for the discovery of the DNA, the structure of DNA? X-ray crystallography. And third checkpoint is that who discovered the structure of DNA, that is Watson and Crick. And that's why when we use the sentence, or when asked the question, who is, means who discovered the structure of DNA, our answer always Watson and Crick, because Watson and Crick analyze, study whatever the model in front of them, means how the nitrogenous bases are arranged, how the helix structure look alike, what is the diameter, what is the dimension. These all information was given by these two scientists, Watson and Crick. Hence Watson and Crick is called as the discoverer of the structure of DNA. But regarding, if we ask question, does Watson and Crick perform the experiment? No. Who performed the experiment? Answer is that R. Franklin and M. Wilkins. Understand? So this is the important checkpoint regarding its discovery. So in front of whiteboard, you can see the structure of DNA. So first of all, Regarding its structure, how it look like? DNA is a double helix structure. DNA is a double helix structure, and if we draw an imaginary line, it helically twisted with each other around its imaginary line. In which direction? Clockwise direction. Which direction? Clockwise. So first important thing is that DNA is the double helix structure, revolve around in its imaginary line in clockwise direction. Okay, so what is the direction? Clockwise direction. So regarding this diagram, it has two strands. Okay, this is the one strand and this one is the second strand, which are helically twist with each other, coil around in each other. Means if you see the first point, structure of each strand, regarding this, each strand is called as polynucleotide strand, right? This strand is called as polynucleotide strand, which is made up of by many DNA nucleotide. And if you see the ladder shape structure, you can see this is one DNA nucleotide, this is second, this is third, this is fourth, for example, again further, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, and so on. In this way, thousand to millions of DNA nucleotide present in one DNA strand. It is depend on the length of DNA too. Understand? In this way, regarding the structure of each polynucleotide strand, actually each DNA is a polynucleotide strand, means it is made up of by many DNA nucleotide. After that, it has two strands. Okay, now one is run in 5' 3' direction, and second 3', 5' direction. If you see, this is like two strand and draw ladder shape structure, 5', 3', this one is 3', and then after what? 5'. Understand? So if you see, these strands are parallel, but the orientation of direction is different. Means if one strand is run in 5' to 3', okay, that is 5' to 3', then another strand run in 3' to 5'. Understand? Means if you consider line, one line goes in this direction and another line goes in opposite direction. Means these are parallel. But which type of parallel? They are anti-parallel. So next important point is that two strands are anti-parallel. How? Two strands are anti-parallel. Then after, as I said, each strand is a polynucleotide strand, and each polynucleotide strand is made up of by DNA nucleotide. If you consider, this is one DNA nucleotide, see. And what is the component of DNA nucleotide? They are pentose sugar, that is deoxyribose sugar, nitrogenous bases. Which nitrogenous bases are present? A, G, C, T. Then after, phosphate. Understand? So first important point is that how these one nucleotide assemble? Nitrogenous base attached to the first carbon by which bond? Glycoside. Phosphate attached to the fifth carbon by which bond? That is phosphoester bond. But when one nucleotide is attached to the second nucleotide, here one phosphate make bonding with two nucleotide, first at third carbon position and second at fifth carbon position, and here two ester bond formation takes place. That's why in between the two nucleotide, which linkage is present? Phosphodiester the linkage. Understand? Now, so here majority, which component of the nucleotide is responsible for the formation of the backbone of DNA? So this is the DNA. So this one what? Backbone. Understand? So who is responsible for the formation of backbone of DNA? Answer is, that is sugar, deoxyribose sugar, pentose sugar and phosphate. Means here, that is, see here I wrote sugar and phosphate, they form the backbone of DNA. Okay, sugar and phosphate form the backbone of DNA. Understand? Then after, as I said, DNA contain two strands. If one strand running 5'3' direction, then another strand running 3'5' direction. So how this nomenclature carried out? Means how this 5' and 3' write at the time of representation of the DNA molecule? Answer is same. See, this is called as the polarity of DNA strand. How this polarity carried out? First of all, means if we take some nucleotides and I draw ladder shape structure, just right to the helix structure. So see the linkage. This is the 5 carbon, means phosphate is attached to the 5th carbon. Thereafter, here, that is 3rd carbon is that OH group. Means at 5th carbon, phosphate is present, and at the end of the nucleotide, if you consider this, at 3rd carbon, OH group is present. So 5 prime represents the attachment of 5th carbon at the first nucleotide of the 5th, attachment of the phosphate group in the first nucleotide of the 5th carbon, and 3 prime represent as free OH group is present at the 3rd carbon. Understand? Second, here also you can see at the first nucleotide, here at 3 prime free OH group is present, this 3 prime represent that's at the 3rd carbon now, and here at the end of the last nucleotide, phosphate is attached to the 5th carbon, and that's why I write here, or we write here 5 carbon. In this way, actually this arrangement represents the polarity of strand. That's why at the time of writing of or nomenclature the orientation of strand, we write 5 prime or 3 prime, yeah, 3 prime or 5 prime strand, and hence it is also called as antiparallel. Understand? Second important checkpoint. Now, DNA show complementary base pairing, but DNA show complementary base pairing. Now, complementary base pairing means what? As you know very well, DNA contain the 4 nitrogenous bases, adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine. Understand? Of which adenine and guanine are purine and cytosine and thymine are called as pyrimidine. In this way, which base ratio is present in the DNA? Another checkpoint for you all. Which base ratio is present in the DNA? That is A plus G upon T plus C. This is the base ratio. Okay. But where these nitrogenous bases are present in the DNA? Which nitrogenous base make a pair with which type of nitrogenous base. Here you should know, in the complementary base pairing, purine always pair with a pyrimidine. Okay, now which are the purine bases? Adenine and guanine. Okay, so in this way, and which are the pyrimidine bases? Thymine and cytosine. So at the time of base pairing, if one strand contain adenine nitrogenous base, they always pair with thymine with two hydrogen bond. Okay, or with thymine, or vice versa, you can say thymine pair with adenine with two hydrogen bond. Means the base pairing always present in the DNA, A with T with two hydrogen bond, or vice versa, means T with A with two hydrogen bond. Unlike this, when guanine present in one strand, it always pair with the cytosine with three hydrogen bond, or vice versa, cytosine pair with guanine with three hydrogen bond. Means A always pair with T and vice versa, and G always pair with C and vice versa. But how many hydrogen bonds are present in between them? That is, in A and T, two hydrogen bond is present, and G and C, three hydrogen bond is present. Or T and A, same, two hydrogen bond, C and G, that is three hydrogen bond. This is called as complementary base pairing. Understand? And on the basis of this, suppose out of these two strands, if 5' 3' strand is called as a template strand. Now template strand means what? It is the parent strand. And the nitrogenous basis of template strand always decide the nitrogenous basis of opposite strand. Means, if suppose template strand contain A nitrogenous bases, then opposite strand always contain T nitrogenous base and for two hydrogen bond. Again, we can take some example. If G is present, then pair with C with three hydrogen bond. If C is present, pair with G with three hydrogen bond. If T is present, pair with A with two hydrogen bond. In this way, as I said, out of the two strand, the one strand is called as template strand, means whose nitrogenous bases decide the pairing or basis of opposite strand. And that's why the opposite strand is called as complementary strand. That is complementary strand. This is called as complementary base pairing. Understand? After that, DNA always show, means DNA show again one property that is called as charge off rule. See, charge off rule or charge off ratio. Erwin Chargaff, this scientist, first of all established this ratio. Means how this ratio explained? According to Chargaff, in the DNA molecule, purine always equal to pyrimidine. Means if the number of purine, means number of purine and number of pyrimidine is always equal to 1 in the DNA. Understand? How? A plus G plus is equal to T plus C. Means in this way, A pair with T and G pair with C is equal to what? 1, na? A pair with T and means here what I write, A plus T is equal to G plus C is equal to 1. Means we can write, a plus t upon g plus c is equal to 1. Means purine and pyrimidine number are always equal to 1. This is called as charge up ratio. Now, how means understand this point. It is very important, and on the basis of this, some numerical may ask in the competitive examination on the basis of this topic. I take one example. If one of the DNA contain 100 nucleotides, of which, on the basis of this, first of all, understand in simplest way, if the DNA contain 100 nucleotides, means on the basis of this explanation, on the basis of this Charge-Up rule, means purine and pyrimidine is equal to 1, now purine and pyrimidine ratio is equal to 1, that is A plus T upon G plus C is equal to 1, it always. So, if one of the DNA contain 100 nucleotide, it means that 50 are purine and 50 are pyrimidine. Means A 25U, G 25U, C 25U, T 25U, that's all. This is the point, what I mean to say. Okay, if one of the DNA contain 1000 nucleotides, it means the all nitrogenous bases numbers are same. Means it should be 250 each. Adenine 250, guanine 250, cytosine 250, thymidine 250. Understand? This is called as Charge-Up ratio. Now, which type of question asked in the NEET examination? Suppose in a bacterial cell, the DNA contain 1200 nucleotides, of which adenine is 250. Understand? Adenine is 250. Now, if adenine is 250, means same number of thymine must present the means thymine may also 250. So 250 to 250, 500. Understand? Now 1200 minus 500, it should be 700 remaining. Na? So now divide the guanine and cytosine in the 700. Out of the 700, 350 should be 350 are guanine and remaining 350 are cytosine. Understand? So here in some of the questions, only one of the nitrogenous bases number is given and ask for another nitrogenous basis. Like I told you one example, means out of the 1200 nucleotides, the adenine nucleotide is 250, then how many guanine nucleotides is present? So your answer should be 350. What is it? 350. So such a type of question may ask, but it is not difficult, it is very simple. So don't take load. Okay, this is about Charge-Up rule. Now, majority of students confuse between two ratio. This Charge-Up rule is also called as Charge-Up ratio. So that which ratio? Base ratio and Charge-Up ratio. So don't be confused here. Charge-Up ratio is A plus T upon G plus C is equal to 1. And base ratio is that A plus G upon T plus C. So don't be confused in between these two ratio. Okay. And both the ratio asked in the examination. What is the base ratio in DNA? Your answer should be A plus G upon T plus C. And what is the Charge-Up ratio in DNA? That is A plus T upon G plus C. Understand? That's all. Now, next one. Actually, this DNA, when helically twisted with each other, it forms two groups. Okay. And which are they? That is major group. The deep depression is called as major group, and the shallow depression is called as minor group. Now understand this concept. How these major group and minor groups are formed? Major groups are formed due to the coiling of strand. This is the deep depression. Okay. And Minor grooves are formed due to the twisting of strand, where strands are coiled with each other. At that time, the deep depressions are produced, that is called as major groove. And at the time of twisting, means this is called twisting of these two strands, the shallow depression is formed, that is called as minor groove. Understand? Thereafter, regarding its dimension, important one. First of all, understand this point. After that, we will continue. It is double helical. Regarding its discovery, I told you that double helix structure, clockwise direction, how this orientation right, and on the basis of this, how this orientation right? The answer is that polarity of strand. Then after, how these two strands are anti-parallel, then complementary base pairing, then base ratio and charge off ratio. Okay, and what is the difference between the base ratio and charge off ratio? We completed. Now next one is that its dimension. Next one is that dimension. Dimension means what? The measurement of DNA. Now first of all, distance between two nitrogenous bases. Distance between two nitrogen base pair is this one. It is always 3.4 angstrom. See this one, it is always 3.4 angstrom. Because the distance between two nitrogenous bases is always 3.4 angstrom. Now, second, angle of each nitrogenous base. Angle of nitrogenous base is that 36 degree always. Always means every nitrogenous base, when arranged with each other, it forms 36 degree angle. That is called as angle of nitrogenous base. Then after, when at the time of coiling of two strands, when the one circle completed, that is called as one helix turn. So, what is the one helix turn? Is 360 degree. No doubt, if it called as a circle or circumference, that is always, it is 360 degree. So one helix turn is always how much? If suppose this is the strand, so this is the one helix turn, is always 360 degree. Now, in one helix turn, how many nitrogenous base pairs are present? Nitrogenous base pair in one helix turn. It is always 10 nitrogenous base pair, means 20 nitrogenous bases. If someone asks you question, how many nitrogenous bases are present, your answer should be 20. And how many nitrogenous base pairs are present, your answer should be 10. Okay, now what is the length? Length of one helix turn. It is very simple, you can calculate. If 10 nitrogenous base pair is present in one helix turn and the distance between two nitrogenous base pair is 3.4, then 3.4 angstrom into 10. 10 is how much? 34 angstrom. That is 34 angstrom is the one length of one helix turn. And last one, which is an important one, that is what is the diameter of DNA? Diameter of DNA It is 20 and strong. 20 and strong. Understand? That's all. So this measurement is in angstrom. Now you should know one important thing, that is 1 nanometer is equal to 10 angstrom, so that you can write these dimension or measurement in a nanometer too. If we see distance between nitrogenous base pair 3.4 angstrom means 1 nanometer is equal to 10. So calculate and write 0.34 nanometer. This unit is important here, otherwise it may wrong. Okay, regarding this 34 angstrom, so 3.4 nanometer, and most of the student make confusion here. Actually the length of one helix turn is 3.4 nanometer, because 3.4 nanometer and 3.4 angstrom. Okay, here in this 2 point you can make confusion, so clear this confusion. I told you unit is important. Okay, and diameter of DNA, no doubt, 0.2 nanometer. That's all. Understand? So as I say, this is about the dimension, and regarding this strand, it is the polynucleotide strand which are helically twisted with each other. First of all, what we studied up to this point, its discovery, Watson and Crick, Franklin, and you know, Watson and Crick discovered the structure of DNA along with his co-worker, and for this precious discovery, these all scientists awarded by the Nobel Prize. Then another important thing is that regarding its structure, its two strand helically twisting direction, that is clockwise direction, and a right-handed two. After that, how these strands are arranged, DNA nucleotide, how make attached with each other by which linkage, that is called phosphodiester linkage, and that is which is the backbone of DNA, we should know, that is pentose sugar, and this is pentose sugar and phosphate. Okay, and which bond present between the two strands, no doubt, that is hydrogen bond. Which bond present between the, here you can write in the dimension, bond present in both strand is which one? Hydrogen bond, that is hydrogen bond. Understand? And last one, what we studied, that is dimension. The whole dimension is present in front of you. Understand? This is about what? DNA structure. Now the last topic is that types of DNA. Actually, in this world, two types of objects are present, living and non-living, alive and non-alive. And the life is made up of a cell where DNA is present. But this DNA is of 5 type. So which are they? So 5 types of DNA. Next one, types of DNA, which are they? That is DNA A, DNA bridge, DNA A, then DNA B, DNA C, DNA D, and then after DNA Z. Okay, and here only dimension is different. All the types of DNA contain two strands. Both are helically twisted with each other. Only regarding the dimensions, its number is different, or you can say its direction is also different. Some are clockwise, some are anti-clockwise. Then after some are right handed, some are left handed. So how it is? See, first on the basis of point we write here base pair per term. First of all, base pair per term. Okay. Base pair per turn. So per helix turn, how many base pairs are present? As you know, 11, 10, okay, then after 9.33, 8, and this one is that what? 12. Okay, next one is coiling. No doubt these are right handed, but ZDNA is left handed. See, last one is diameter. Diameter, see, 23 angstrom, 20 angstrom, 21 angstrom. Then after it's 19 angstrom, and this one is that 18 angstrom. Okay. So on the basis of these three characteristics, we just understand the types of DNA. Otherwise, if you see the structure or the DNA nucleotide components all are same. Only in some points they show differences, right? The base pair per turn, that is 11th in BDNA, ADNA, 10 in BDNA, it's base pair, in number is present in the form of pair. 9.33 in cDNA, 8 in DDNA, 12 in zDNA. Interesting thing is that regarding its coiling, its direction, A, B, C, D are right-handed and Z are left-handed. Then its diameter 23 angstrom, 20, 21, 19, and then what, 90. You can take another characteristic like its direction. So A, B, C and D are clockwise direction, clockwise, okay. But Z, its direction is anti-clockwise, understand? And here, again, you can check the important thing is, whatever studied before some time regarding its structure, it is the B form of DNA. Okay, so those structure we studied before some time, it is a B type DNA. Which one? B type. And in fact, in most of the living beings, 99.99% you can say that is B type of DNA is present. So in this way, in today's structure, we have completed the structure of DNA. In the next video, we will study about RNA.